And we're back with a band that I have only covered once on the channel so far. This is going to be the new Pure Reason Revolution album, Coming Up to Consciousness. The thing that really caught my ear the most when first discovering them were how interesting and unique the vocal melodies were and the harmonies throughout all of their music, all of their instrumentation. They create very abstract, very specific moods, and it helps the music feel a lot more realized for me, so I was very curious to see where they would go from here. I can draw lots of parallels to the likes of Steven Wilson and Porcupine Tree in their sound and among their influences, but they deal with both a male and female singer, so definitely some interesting pairings going on, and overall a very meditative, very beautiful modern prog experience from what I've heard so far. Though I haven't heard much, I have not been checking out the singles. I did hear the first one, Dig Till You Die, and I skimmed my way through the second single, but only once, and I don't remember anything about the track. So for the most part, I'm going into this blind, and I'm very curious about how they're composing this and what the story is, because from what I can tell, the only two albums that I've heard from them so far are concept albums, and with 14 songs on a 40-minute album, there are definitely to be some interludes, connecting songs, shorter moments, and I'm just curious to see how they all speak to each other. So let's just check it out. I don't have much else to add. Let's jump right into Coming Up to Consciousness by Pure Reason Revolution. And we have a prelude to start everything off here. I'm really excited for this one. I enjoyed a lot of what I heard the first time I heard this band, but they have been a serious grower over time. Some very interesting, catchy moments, and just one that I'm excited for their future, because it is something very different to what I've heard before. Man, I almost wish they posted that prelude with the single. I love that transition into it. And this song too, ever since my first time hearing it, has grown a lot. This intro and the outro to the song are absolutely beautiful. So many details and interesting elements to that soundscape. I love how the female vocals blend in with him there in that transition. Incredibly produced album. I don't know if they recently signed with Inside Out Music or if they had been there, but man, excellent mixing. Again, that transition. I would have to say, from what I've heard as well, you know, without knowing anything else about the album, I would say this song is a very good intro to their sound, especially after hearing it many times now. I've heard it in many different contexts, many different moods, and I really like this one now. I do still want to figure out what the song is about. I haven't really looked into it, but all the time changes, key changes and everything, there's got to be something there with the message. Like, my brain's telling me that something's off in here, because we were just bobbing along to this melody much slower. I love this part of the song. hear on the way out, this whole outro is incredible. This lullaby-esque kind of element to their sound is my favorite. When they get into these pockets, that's what I love the most about these guys. That piano run to the transition. There's that Porcupine Tree guitar tone. Reminding me of the start of Something Beautiful a little bit. Just in that tone. A tone that needs to be utilized more. And when he hits that falsetto note coming up. So good, man. This song builds super well and has a lot of interesting creative elements for a 4-minute song. It's impressive. It really is. Are there going to be interludes between every song? Kind of like that. Something different for sure, because you think 40 minutes, 14 songs, that's like not even 3 minutes per song, so at least half of those have to be short, surely. Well, yeah, that one was what, 20 seconds? Betrayal, I believe, was the last single before the album, which I have not heard yet, so. Fresh ears from here on out. My brain telling me he's gonna say, cool deliverance. If you haven't heard that song, go check it out. Interesting groove. Very raw. Lots of greens and emeralds swirling around me right now. With a bit of a darker kind of undertone. Very interesting with my synesthesia. And that's one thing I remember about Dig Till You Die too, especially with all those little details. Colors were going all over the place for me. Ooh. Oh my god, I'm saving this already. Really nice. The vocal layers. Man, I love this so far. That was one of my favorite sections in anything I've heard from them so far. Perfect, tight little melodies, little poking elements of falsetto. The masters of detail, these guys. Love that little, that synth in the background almost feels a little bit like, has a woodwind kind of feel to it. Oh, more of this. It's just so nice. It's easy to listen to. but interesting enough to make you want to listen again. Bring those vocals out a little more. Come on, we're building, we gotta build. Nothing against this part. Interesting. Might like it better than Dig Till You Die on first listen. Next up is Gallows, The Gallows, which is 4 minutes. So there is not an interlude between every song, but I'm sure there'll be a few. Ooh. Is that guitar with lots of reverb and kind of... reminding me of one of my favorite melodies of theirs so far. The way those all escalated up. Such a beautiful melancholy it had. I have to say it's been a very gentle album so far. And I would say they are definitely a prog rock band. They're not a prog metal band, but they... all of their other albums had a fair share of more upbeat, heavier moments. I'm not saying I need that or want that. My favorite songs of theirs are actually these more delicate, ballad type of songs. But I'm very interested if this album builds in that way or if it stays like this. Super catchy right now. The drum production is ridiculous. The kit sounds so good. Harmonica? Oh my god, if you're bringing out a harmonica solo on me. Please don't tell me that was just a little... Come on. Please, please turn that into something. Please do a harmonica solo. That would be so sick. An homage to Refuge by Steven Wilson. I'm liking the pacing of this song though. It's super smooth. Color overloads. Harmonica! They better bring that back. But hey, sometimes it's good to tease someone like that. That means it sounded good, right? If you want more. I think the song's gonna end like this. Very interesting outro. very delicate, kind of staying in its own pocket, its own kind of jam. Super interesting. Takes a lot of balls to end a song like this. I absolutely love the feel of this section. I'm impressed. I feel like whatever's coming next is gonna be a bit more heavy. Ooh. Talk about stripping it back. We have another interlude. Definitely a different tone to the song. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh, this is a swayer. Nice. I really liked how they kept adding layers to the harmonies there, and the vocals were kind of counteracting the tone of those keyboards in the background, pushing out of it, trying to lift out of it. Nice contrast. Ooh. But move back and forth. That's a good sign, man. Gonna strip it back now, a little breathing space. That was a beautiful chorus. Infectious stuff again. I love the pulse, that 6/8 feel. It wasn't a full kind of triplet bounce, which I like. That can have a little bit of an oakiness to it in a way sometimes. It had a steadiness, which I like, but still bouncy. Oh! That is not what I was expecting, especially based on how this album has gone on. I knew it. Some very proggy, the use of those organs, very Riverside. Nice. I like that. Oh, this chorus. Oh, I'm saving this one too. Damn! There is such a massive sound to those harmonies that they use. Ooh, a little variation? Nice! Very tight song. Loved how that one was composed. Awesome stuff. Great stuff there. That chorus, because it's not like the vocals aren't like unleashing themselves. They're not screaming on the top of their lungs. It's fairly subdued, like a Stephen Wilson would, but those harmonies have so much power to them on their own. There's such a warmth. It has such a large, complete soundscape. Super impressive the way they managed to hone that in so well. I bet it's incredible live, too, if they can pull it off. Worship. You're holding for till I'm together. Now heaven feels better and better. It's true. You rip the bursting light. Another slower intro. Curious if they're going to start any more out of the gates, kind of like Dig Till You Die. It's cool. It grips you, burst the mind. I will never get tired of their singing style like that, though. Ooh. Oh, I love the delivery of that note. Purples everywhere from that guitar tone. Beautiful phrasing, the slides. Background vocals. They're gonna take this and they're gonna add more to it. They're stripping back the guitars and stuff, everything. They're gonna make it punch more now, I can tell, that contrast. Ooh! Whoa! Tonal shift. Whoa. Oh, shit. Seriously? I will be shocked if these guys throw a drop like that in here. Excuse me. Fix my contact up there a little. Oh, such a tease. Never mind. Those tones are so heavy when they're building. I wish those breaks were even harder. But man, they still hit. Absolutely perfect transition. We definitely got our answer though. This album has plenty of a balance between these heavier moments and the kind of lullabies. The synths are ridiculous. So much texture. Man, that was a jam. Yeah, saving this one as well. Sorry, did not mean to pause there. Wow. Again, that tone, you heard the tone back there. That sounded heavy. So those drops didn't quite have that. They still have that kind of prettiness and that gloss to them. I would love to see these guys just let loose a little, just once. But if that's not what the song calls for, then it's not what it calls for. I'm not gonna complain. Thought that was a great song. I like the title of the next song, Bend the Earth. Sounds powerful.
I want to be alone.
Electronic style.
And when I'm alone, I want to be alone.
Bit of a longer one too. We got a 6-minute track in here. Let's do this. I don't know if that was a key change, but that sure felt nice. Very interesting drum groove as well. I'm enjoying it, I like this. Just kind of shuffling forward. Damn, that was a jump. Yeah. I think their synth game has gone way up on this album. We're swaying again. Can't help myself. Really tasteful details back there with the synths and that bass. Very unique song structuring here. And all these layers. That's the benefit of adding that many layers. When you want to strip back and you want to lower the pace of things, it's a lot easier to create a contrast with the dynamics. You can definitely tell that's there. You know, those peaks of the story, they really hit when you feel them, because they add all those layers. They can throw them all in at once, or they can pull them all back at once. So those high impact points and those quieter moments, there is a much more, there's a deeper contrast between them. All these layers in this production help a lot with that. There we go. I love that synth line in the background. Because again, such a weird contrast between the tone of that and the vocals. The sweetness, kind of angelic tone to the vocals. There's still an intensity and a bit of a warning. It's creeping up on you, those synths. And then you go into this and it's all sweet. Their contrast, their balance, transitions, dynamics. They got them all locked in. Ooh. very interesting buildup in that section. Got lost in it. I have to say, almost forgot that I was recording for a second. Always a good thing when a band can do that. Nice. Let the synth shine for a little before the vocals come back in. Excellent writing. Transition. Whoa. So much intentionality between all these little details and decisions and effects. I have to know what they're talking about on this album, these songs. I gotta know the story. I know I always say that. I feel like I say that in every reaction, but I'm definitely applying it to these guys because everything is so, it feels so intentional. Because every song has all of these, like, dozens of little sounds and swirling effects, tones. You don't hear the same synth tone, the same piano, the same bass tone, the same amount of reverb or texture on each song. It's different and personalized every time, though they still have a very Pure Reason Revolution gloss to them all. That's great writing. It really is. Whoa, I didn't even realize they changed songs. Holy shit. We got another 6 minute job here. Wow. That was a great transition. The stare of their faces on the screen is very entrancing. The way they're kind of looking up. And that little keyboard arpeggio on its way down. So happy. I'm sure it will actually gain a little happiness, a little sweetness. Because they always do. That's one of the things that I praise the most about my favorite bands like Vola. They can sing about the most devastating things, but they still have a great sense of melody. And it adds a sweetness to it and a listenability to it that doesn't drag all the way down on you. But they still make the emotion very apparent. So much atmosphere. Back a little itchy there. Nice little triplets there on the kick. It's the little things. Saying a lot with a little. Very curious where this one builds to from here. Every time I think, well, they should shift here by now, they should go do something like this. They're one step ahead of me. I was gonna say, I don't think they should drop it back down from there. And now it makes more sense, because they lifted it up a little bit more. Now that contrast is more apparent. album got me all relaxed in here. That tone, that little chord shift. I'm so lost in this. I apologize for not saying much, but sometimes that's best. When the music really grabs a hold of you, building slowly but surely, expertly done. Why do they love doing this? I thought for sure there's no way they can tease a drop this time, surely. Ooh. Really nice. And they brought back that piano part from the intro. Prelude 5 coming up. Or interlude, sorry. Can't be 5 preludes. Interesting, is there going to be another song after or no? I would hope it ends with the song. Ending where it began. Man, I really like that ending. All right, one last song after this. Let's see how they end this album. I love that piano melody. Album keeps pulling me under. I gotta keep my eyes open, I think, is the big part of it. I like to close my eyes because of my synesthesia. The colors are so much more apparent. But, man. I'm already saving this one, too. It hasn't even gotten going. Stephen Wilson would be proud. I really think so. rings. Know what to talk about. Every detail is perfect in this section. The piano is what's standing out the most. Full-on Northern Lights show going on. This might be my favorite one on the album. I do love an album saving the best for last. It's an incentive to listen to the album again. The production just makes so much sense for this song in particular. Oh. I love this so much. It's just making me smile. Such a mix of emotions. That guitar is bouncing off of the piano so well. Oh, it's the best song. This is the best one on the album. Yes. Oh my god, the piano is just tugging on my heartstrings. Such a delicacy and... Yeah, wow. What a great way to end the album. Perfect little... Just... Such a sweet little arrangement. Man, that was some great stuff in there. There was some great stuff in there. All in all, I have to say, I'm largely impressed with that album and all the care and thought that went into it. It's very short for their standards, and the interludes are a new kind of addition to their sound, from what I believe, to their style as well. And as with the rest of their stuff for me, those melodies and those vocal harmonies are absolutely what stand out the most. But with this album in particular, there was so much contrast between the little things from song to song. That's what varied the album up and kept it interesting, even though it was very much in the same tone and the same flavor. You can tell exactly who you're listening to, but each song has its own specific little palette with these little details where you can tell them apart, you can tell the characters of the songs apart, and they are so specific and so intentional. I think there's beautiful writing in there in that sense because it's subtle but so many layers, and the fact that something with that many details, that many layers, that many elements can be so easy to listen to and relaxing is impressive, especially in the prog genre. And I would have to say that while I don't think this band has truly blown my mind with anything yet, it's all been great so far. I think this album has been great all the way through. There isn't much that I would complain about or that I would change. It's just all very solid, very tight writing, and something great to put on in the background or to study to or to listen to on a nice drive. Great textures, great atmosphere, great production. A very, very, very solid modern prog album that is not overdoing it in any capacity. With that said, I would still love to see them take more risks because those melodies seem to be their kind of signature thing. They are all fairly similar in some capacity. They like to hit their falsettos. There are plenty of harmonies in them, and they all kind of feel like they're in the same realm. So within those, maybe the heavier moments, some of those instrumental tangents, I would like to see a little bit more branching out, something to truly surprise me, truly shock me. Because all those little things, all those little variances, they're in there, they're different, they're interesting, but they're not driving anything anywhere in particular. It's just making the groove and the jam of it a little bit more interesting. It's not pivoting it to completely new territory. So I'm still waiting for that. I'm still waiting for those big risks to be taken. And I think once that happens, I can go up and say that I truly love an album, or I truly adore one of their songs. So far, I just think everything has been good and great, and there's nothing to complain about there. I just think there are steps and there is maturity to be seen still. There is no problem with taking risks in the prog community. No one will criticize you for that. And that's what this kind of genre is for. It's progressing things and pushing it forward. I think these guys have made enough albums now to go ahead and try something different. I think you've absolutely nailed on and found what your sound is up to this point. And I don't know if you can get any better at doing what you are doing. I think from what we've heard so far, and for the tones that are seen in this album, that's as good as you can do it. This is as well as you can make an album like this. Did that make sense? This is as well as you can make an album that is like this. I hope that makes sense, but I think within this capacity, just to shorten it, this album is as good as it can be for what it is. There are still some standouts regardless. I think there are certain songs where those excellent melodies and harmonies were even better than the rest, particularly the singles that I didn't hear. So I'm glad that I didn't have those peak moments spoiled for me before the album, especially Useless Animal and Betrayal. I think my one last critique again would be, when you're teasing those breakdowns and those heavier moments and those tones, there are so many great elements and interesting ideas that go into those build-ups, new textures, and those were the moments in the album where I heard the most new territory going on. I thought we were gonna go somewhere we'd never gone with the band, but it feels like they wanted to throw all of those moments into the build-up, but they were just a little hesitant to throw them all out there in a breakdown or in the release. All of those buildups kind of resulted in them just suddenly stripping it all back and then going in somewhere similar, a little bit heavier, or just kind of going up to another chorus or melody. But none of those releases really satisfied me. They still felt like a bit of a tease because the buildups were so good. They felt like they deserved a proper release and a proper impact. Let me know what you guys thought. Let me know what your favorite songs are, your favorite melodies. If you haven't heard the band before, will you go check them out from this? Because if this was my intro to the band, I think I would definitely go back and look. Pure Reason Revolution are the master of details, and I can't wait to see them be the master of a different sphere and a different sound one day. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you all next time.